Not sure where to start when it comes to your AP Chem studying? Then stay tuned, because in this video, we're gonna go over 15 study tips that you can start using to score that 4 or 5 on your AP Chem exam. We'll start out by talking about what you can do at home to prep for your AP Biology exam, how to start studying specifically for the multiple choice section, and then wrap up with some free response tips. Without further ado though, let's jump into today's video. The first thing you're gonna wanna do when you're prepping for your AP Chem exam is to remove as many distractions as possible from your surrounding environment. This means, for example, leaving your phone in another room so that you don't get distracted to check it while you are studying for your exam. Trust me, it's rare that something that happens on Snapchat is actually so important that you have to check it immediately when you receive that snap. After you've removed your distractions, it's time to focus. To do so, we recommend that you use the Pomodoro technique. This is where you're gonna have 25 minutes of uninterrupted focus, followed by 5-minute breaks every 30 minutes. Then, after you've gone through 3 cycles of this, give yourself a 15-minute break. This method will give you enough time to make sure that you're truly focused in your studying, while also giving your brain enough time to take a small break along the way. The second tip when it comes to at-home studying for AP Chem is to be consistent with your study schedule. All it takes really is 15 to 20 minutes every single day, the month leading up to your exam, to feel really good about your AP Chem prep. Whatever time you're able to budget earlier on in your studying for AP Chem will take off some of the stress or pressure for you to cram the night before the exam. So we recommend that you block away at least 2 to 3 study days every single week for you to review key concepts that you might be struggling with in AP Chem. Tip 3 is to learn how to use your calculator. It's gonna be super helpful for some calculations on your test, so you wanna make sure you feel super comfortable with the particular calculator that you're going to use on test day. Tip 4 is to use Quizlet to review key terms on the go. You can also use more direct review resources like Albert if you're looking to get some practice in, but the purpose of this tip is to make sure that you are making the most of your in-between time. In-between time could be, for example, when you are traveling for some sort of school event, or when you just have some downtime in which you could be productive with that time. Whether it's flashcards on Quizlet or it's actual practice questions on Albert, the important thing is that you are getting familiar with the sorts of concepts that are going to be tested of you on test day and the ways that those concepts are asked to you on the AP Chemistry exam. Our fifth tip when it comes to studying at home is to study with a friend. One of the best ways that you can truly master some concepts is to make sure that you can actually teach it to somebody else. Or in the case where you don't know that concept, that you can learn it from somebody else other than your teacher. Sometimes simply just hearing something get explained to you in different terminology than how your teacher may have explained it or how you saw it in some review video can go a long way in your prep. As much as possible, we recommend regularly scheduling study groups for you guys to meet. Or if you find it even more helpful to have a small group for more conversation and more perspectives, then create a small study group that consistently meets. This can be either in person or virtual, depending on what is more convenient and safe for everybody. Before we start talking about some specific AP Chemistry multiple choice tips, if you're finding this video helpful, do us a favor and hit that like button below. By doing so, you'll help more AP Chem students like yourself discover this video. The first tip when it comes to doing well in your AP Chemistry multiple choice section is to make sure that you're pacing yourself. Here, you're gonna have 90 minutes to answer 60 questions. This gives you about 1.5 minutes or 90 seconds to answer every single question. So you wanna make sure that you're not building a bad study habit of spending 2 to 3 minutes on every single question, because that would mean that you're not giving yourself ample time to give your best attempt on every single question. In the case where something's taking you way too long, build a system for yourself, whether that's circling the question or leaving a star next to the question, so that you know later on that you need to go back to that question and review it again. The second tip we can give you is to come up with your own answer choices before you read the answer choices that are given to you. This can be a great way for you to anticipate what the correct answer might be or what is the best correct answer choice based on the things that are presented to you. In the case where you're using an online resource like Albert, you can check out the detailed answer explanations for every single answer choice to see why that particular answer choice was right or wrong. Tip 3 is to make sure to carefully review any visual materials that are provided to you. This means, for example, in graphs, looking at the labels, the axes, the points that are plotted, as well as the trends that are emerging from the data that's being shared with you. One of the key skills in AP Science classes is the ability to look at data and actually draw analysis from that data and interpret it. Tip number four is to make sure that you're ready to handle questions in sets. Sometimes AP Chemistry gives you questions in sets of 2 to 4 questions, in which those questions are going to be related to one another. Now, that being said, typically all the questions are independent enough from one another that you will be able to answer each question regardless of how you felt about the prior question. Either way, the important thing for you to remember here is to not get psyched out if you don't get the first question right. You can still get the 2nd through 4th questions right in these question sets. But practice getting familiar with question sets because you're bound to see them on your AP Chemistry exam. And the last multiple choice tip is to leave enough time to check your work. It's helpful to leave at least 10 to 15 minutes at the end of your multiple choice section so you can review those questions that you may have circled or starred to come back to later. Remember, you don't get points knocked off when you get questions wrong. You only earn points for getting questions right. So it makes sense for you to give your best effort on every single one of your AP Chemistry multiple choice questions. Now let's jump into some quick hitting AP Chemistry free response tips. The first tip for you is to make sure that you're keeping track of your time. When it comes to the AP Chemistry free response section, you're gonna have 105 minutes or 1 hour and 45 minutes to answer 7 questions. 3 of these questions are going to be longer questions that are going to be worth 10 points each. So it's really important that you block at least 20 minutes to answer each of these questions. And then the 4 remaining questions are going to be short answer questions. So these are only going to be worth 4 points. So just budget about 10 minutes for each of these. By taking this sort of approach, you'll leave yourself with 5 minutes to spend on any particular question that may have given you some difficulty the first time that you were answering it. The second tip is to make sure that you're reviewing the past scoring guidelines and rubrics that have been shared with you. The College Board does a great job of giving you a library of previously released free response questions, as well as chief reader reports that document specifically what students did well and didn't do so hot on for that particular year's exam. So it's your job to make sure that you're going through at least 3 years worth of previously released exams to understand the patterns that AP Chemistry students often make when it comes to the free response section. The third tip is to make sure that you're focusing on your task verbs. The College Board loves to use a few focus verbs in all of their questions, and so build the habit of circling or underlining what that task verb is the first time that you read the question. This way, you'll be able to actually know specifically what you need to answer in order to start scoring points on that particular FRQ. For a complete list to those task verbs, check out the link to the accompanying blog article in the video description below. Tip 4 is to make sure that you don't panic when you are unable to answer part A of a multi-part question. In that situation, you just want to come up with a value that you can then carry on to use throughout the remainder of the question. Something to remember is that AP graders are trying to give you credit. So in the case where you can't come up with the right answer choice for part A, come up with a value and use that for parts B through D. Our last free response tip is to remember these must-dos when it comes to your AP Chemistry free response. The first thing to remember is that you don't need to restate the question. Simply focus on answering the question directly of what's being asked of you. The second thing is when there are multiple parts to a free response question, you need to answer every single part. Make it clear to your reader what part of your answer is part A versus part B versus part C and so on. The third thing to remember is that when calculations are required, you need to actually show your work. And this means also making sure that your final answer has units. Students often lose points simply because they forgot to carry over the units of whatever they are calculating when it comes to AP Chemistry. Don't forget to provide units for every single answer and to provide labels when appropriate. It can also be helpful here to reread the question and make sure that your answer choice makes sense. For example, you might come up with an answer that seems too big or too small to the particular question that's being asked of you. In the case where you're asked to create a table or a graph, make sure that whatever you create has a clear title, axes, labels to those axes, as well as points plotted if appropriate. And in the case where you're asked to do so, draw a line or a graph, but don't extrapolate unless you're explicitly asked to do so. It's also super important when you're answering free response questions to be succinct in your answers. It's quality over quantity in order to score points. So make sure that you're closing the loop whenever you are answering a particular question in your AP Chemistry free response section. Sometimes students fall into this trap of sharing everything they know about a particular topic, and it doesn't actually answer the question that's being asked of them. Lastly, when you're making an argument, use the structure of claim, evidence, reasoning. State your claim, provide your evidence for that claim, and then explain your reasoning. By using this structure, you're demonstrating that you truly understand what you are answering and that you didn't just pull that answer out of thin air. There you have it, 15 tips to help you start with your AP Chemistry studying. If you found this video helpful, do us a favor and hit that like button below. Also, consider subscribing for more AP review content like this. We not only have other AP chemistry videos, but we also cover subjects like AP biology, history, and more. Lastly, if you haven't created your free Albert account to practice for your AP chemistry exam, you can do so using the link in the video description below. We have hundreds of practice questions as well as full-length practice tests that you can use to help you score that 4 or 5 on your AP exam. In the case where you're a teacher watching this video, check out our pilot program using the link in the video description below. With it, you'll be able to try Albert out with your school for 30 days. That's it for this time though. While you guys wait for the next video, check out these videos that YouTube thinks you might like.